Welcome to A Minute of Your Day. I'm Carol Howell, and I am so glad you're here. Today, I have a special guest, and I am so honored to be interviewing and bringing to you Mr. Patrick Moffett. Patrick, how are you?
I'm doing well. Thank you, Carol.
And you are in New York? Is that right?
Yes, I'm on Long Island. Yes, I'm on New York.
Long Island, is that what you said? Oh, very good. So, folks, I bring Patrick to you today because he has written a book and also produced a movie. And tell him the name of that.
The name of the book and the movie, same name, is Ice Cream in the Cupboard.
Ice Cream in the Cupboard, which is not your normal thing. Why did you call it that?
Oh, just when things were, before Carmen was diagnosed, she refused to go to a doctor. I was getting so frustrated I couldn't get her to go. And we went food shopping one day and came back and she put the food away and I ran out to the dry cleaners and I came back and I saw this white liquid coming out of the cabinet, that what you call the cupboard.
Oh, not good.
I tracked it down and sure enough, I found a deflated box of Breyers vanilla ice cream. And I said, you know, that's the end of this. She had refused to go to a doctor saying, there's nothing wrong with me. Why do you keep saying that? I said, well, I didn't put the ice cream in here. It's just you, me, and the dog. Because you blame me for everything. You don't blame those kids upstairs. What kids? The kids were long gone.
Oh, my.
I know this was worse and worse. And I said, tomorrow, if I have to, I have to put a net on her, put her in a trunk, and take her to a doctor. But this is the end of the line. Yeah. And the next day, she was working for the school system, and they told her if she didn't go and get an examination by the local hospital, they were going to let her go for cause.
Oh, wow.
And because there was so many mistakes being made on the budget and things she was responsible for. And she did. And she came back to that night. And when I said, I was so frustrated. And she said, just sit down for a minute. She said, I want to tell you something. I have a touch of Alzheimer's. And I said, isn't that kind of being a little bit pregnant?
Yeah, it doesn't exist, does it?
Because I went to the doctor. I'm so sorry. And I'll tell you first. So that's such a pivotal point.
Yes.
Fire event with Carmen. That I named it Ice Cream in the Cupboard.
Such a beautiful name. And it really gets your attention and makes you want to say, what? Why did he call it that?
Exactly.
So now, just quickly, I want to tell the folks that Carmen was diagnosed at the age of 53 with early onset Alzheimer's, which is different than late onset. And it was not an easy journey for you. Real quickly, like in 15 seconds here, tell them about the spaghetti plate.
Plate in Puerto Rico.
Yeah.
I was sitting down having dinner with her and I was looking over the veranda. Everything was nice. I turned back and I got hit in the face with an entire plate of steak and lobster.
That was it.
Yeah. I was laying on the floor. I had no idea what happened. We weren't arguing. We weren't doing anything. We barely just had the dinner arrived. We weren't drinking. That was it. And then she started to run down the street and I had to run after her. The police were running after me as I was running after her. It was just crazy.
And she remembered none of it later.
No, by the time we got back to the hotel, I got it calmed down. She laid down, went to sleep for a little while, and then came out on the terrace where I was sitting and says, honey, I am starved. When are we going to eat? What? You know, I tried that and you threw the food at me. And she said, Moffett, you know, you joke around too much. I wouldn't do that to you. That's ridiculous.
Yeah, bless
her. There's no memory of that gigantic event at all. But I'm 49 years old. She's 53. Am I thinking Alzheimer's? Absolutely not.
No, that doesn't go together. So tell my viewers how they can find your book, find the movie, and participate in this life story of yours.
Well, the book is on Amazon, of course, and it's a print on demand or on Kindle. And the movie is now for Amazon Prime members. It's free. And it's other on the other platforms. It's on YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and a couple others, Fandango. So you can find it around in most on-demand platforms you'll see.
Very good. Thank you for being a part of A Minute of Your Day here for Let's Talk Dementia. And folks, I hope that you see the smile on this man's face and he can look back on his journey. No, he did everything he could do for his wonderful wife, Carmen. And that does help bring peace, does it not, Patrick?
It does. It really does. You always say, I think afterward when she needed full-time care, you know, have I done enough that I fail?
Mm-mm.
You know, meanwhile, people are behind you saying, are you kidding me? You know what you've done?
Yeah.
You're magnificent.
Absolutely.
I could have did better. She's already in a nursing home. How could I have done well? You know,
No, you did a great job.
She's already.
Yeah, I thank you for that. And folks, do check him out, his book on Amazon and then the movie on Amazon Prime and the various other platforms he mentioned. Ice Cream in the Cupboard. I hope you guys have a great day and blessings and smiles on your caregiving journey.
Okay, thank you.